One guy that Matt Stepp caught up with at the Hearst 7-on-7 tournament, or the LD Bell, rather. LD Bell State 7-on-7 tournament. I'm sorry. I'm trying to get the branding right.
It's all right.
Cedar Hill coach Carlos Lynn. I think last year would be considered a bit of a disappointment for Cedar Hill, although they were on like their 15th string quarterback by the time the season was over. I know they are very excited there in TTHL land to see what Coach Carlos Lynn can do down there for the Longhorns. Here is Matt Stepp's interview with Cedar Hill coach Carlos Lynn here on Texas Football Today.
Matt Stepp with Dave Campbell's Texas Football back here at the LD Bell 7-on-7 state qualifier. Here with the head coach of the Cedar Hill Longhorns, my good friend, Coach Carlos Lynn. Coach, good to see you again.
Good morning. Hey, beautiful day, baby. Beautiful day.
It's not too hot yet. We can just keep it like this the rest of the day. I think it'll be all right, right?
It'll be nice. It'll be nice. Yes, sir.
All right, Coach. Obviously, you're out here watching your kids compete in 7-on-7. Going to be one of the world's highest paid, but not quite as good-looking cheerleaders as there are in the world. But you know, you're going to be watching your kids compete. What are you looking to see out of your kids today from a 7-on-7 standpoint? I know it's not real football, but I know there's a lot of things that you and your coaches out here can take back with you, right?
Absolutely. You know, just coming out of spring, you know, hopefully we come out and compete, first of all. And, you know, hopefully have a high level of execution. And, you know, and you know, our goal is to try to, you know, make it to the state, qualify for state as well. So we hopefully the day is not lost if we come out here and do what we're supposed to do and just play hard football, execute, make some plays. It should be a good day for us.
All right. You mentioned just coming out of spring football. Coming into spring, what were some of the objectives you and your coaches had? I know last year didn't go the way you wanted it to go. I mean, that's no secret, and the expectations are always high at Cedar Hill for not only the community but for you personally and for your staff. So what were some of the things you and your coaches wanted to get out of spring ball, and what was your gut feeling coming out of practice?
Well, coming into this spring, we was in such a better place. You know, this time last year, I didn't know who was leaving, who was going, who was coming on staff. We were shorthanded. And this year we felt like we coached from a position of being in front of everything. So just the mindset was totally different. We had a great offseason. Our kids did a great job in powerlifting and track and all of the spring sports. So we felt good going into spring. And I think probably one of the biggest question marks was, you know, trying to plug in some guys in the O-line. And we felt good at the end of the spring coming back. Got some guys that really stepped up, that really showed that they're going to be able to help us. And our defense just played outside of their minds, man. We're light years ahead of where we were last year.
That's kind of a scary thought because you guys are pretty good on the defensive side of the ball last year. I know defensively you were pretty happy with your team's performance last year. So to be ahead of the pace last year, that could be bad news for offenses, hopefully, I'm sure. you know, final question for you, Coach. You know, me and you, we like to talk about food a lot. I love to eat. I know you love to eat, too. When I'm coming to Cedar Hill, now I will admit, Coach Farmer, she takes good care of the press box. She feeds us real well in the press box. But if I want to eat in town before the game, where do I need to go in Cedar Hill to grab a bite to eat?
I tell you what, Campuzano's. Campuzano's Mexican food. I was just there yesterday. Outstanding. I mean, it doesn't matter. You can just close your eyes and run down the menu and just your finger stop. It's all good.
Well, you're a barbecue guy, too, so now we'll ask you this. Now, barbecue, what, you know, if you had to pick one meat, brisket, sausage, ribs, turkey, chicken, what's Coach Lynn picking? If you can only pick one, if you only get the one meat plate, what are you going with?
I'm probably going to go with the brisket.
There you go.
Probably going to go with the brisket.
My man, brisket. There you go, Coach. Appreciate you. Congratulations.
Thank you,
everything, and good luck in 2018, and good luck today for your kids.
Absolutely. I appreciate it.
There
you.
Thanks, is Coach. Carlos Lynn, head coach, Cedar Hill Longhorns, one of our favorites. Good dude.
Yes.
From what I understand, last I saw him in December, I think, at a playoff game, and I asked about, because his son's been battling cancer, I believe.
Yeah.
But from what he told me in December, that things were trending upward. I had to give him a call and check on how his son's doing. But in any case, appreciate him talking a little football ball with Matt Stepp there at the LD Bell 7-on-7 state qualifying tournament.